Hey, buddies, babes, and brandy bucks, are you ready for another ad? Your memory is sharp. Sharp enough, I'm sure, to remember the wildly hilarious advertisement for Crystal Punk, the Magitech 5e supplement. Well, with your support, it managed to rake in 2,100 backers and get over 438% funded. With all of the stretch goals blown open, the path to premium content is clearer than it's ever been. And if you're worried that the train was leaving without you, you'd better hold back those depressing thoughts, kiddo, because the pre-order is live, and you can get your hands on all the juicy rock candy just by clicking the link in the description below and ordering all of that pre. So what are you waiting for? Crystal Punk. It won't tell the future, but neither will real crystals. Oh, you think this is funny, huh? Just put out a UA 2 days before Saturday and forced me to push everything back a week. Did you know that I was going to talk about Pathfinder? And of course it would be about the Fey, as if I didn't have enough to worry about. Howdy, how's it going? My name's Davvy Chappy, and sometimes it feels like this relationship isn't entirely healthy, because today we're going to be going over the new UA that covers four different lineages from my least favorite place, the Feywild. As always, keep in mind that the majority of this is just my opinion, so if you don't share my sentiments about fairies and the fornication thereof, feel free to play your games however you want. But with that out of the way, let's begin. So, the first lineage on the list is something that I cannot talk about by order of de rules, or else my wish to become a famous YouTuber will go away. Regardless, the fairy is a catch-all term for any amount of weird folk that don't necessarily have a famous legend to give them their powers, and so instead, you sort of just get a grab bag of fae-like abilities, plus a random table to generate your fairy's unique quirk. As you may have expected, the fairy's unique creature type is fae, but what's surprising is that it's the only lineage in this UA to actually be fae and not humanoid, and also the only one to be classified as a small creature, since the other lineages are either medium or can choose to be medium or small. Considering the Fey are all about taking form based on their own whims, and that this is seemingly an open-ended lineage, I'm surprised that they can't choose as well. They also have no resistance to charms? What world are we in? Anyway, I'm getting off topic. The actual abilities include Druidcraft, Fairy Fire, and the power to slip through passages as narrow as 1 inch wide so that they'll never be captured, and an unrestricted flying speed that'll either be nerfed into the ground or signal that Wizards is finally coming out of its shell in regards to the racial ban list, now if it can only get over large creatures. Next up, the Hobgoblin of the Feywild is almost completely unlike the Hobgoblin of the Getting Stabbed by My Party, because where the normal Hobgoblin is a medium humanoid with dark vision and the power to hit enemies better if there are people watching, the Feywild Hobgoblin gets all that plus advantage against being charmed and a huge buff to their help action that would make the mastermind blush. The F-Hob, as we'll call it, can use their help action as a bonus action an amount of times equal to their proficiency bonus, but in addition to the normal effects, you can choose to give both you and your helper buddy temporary HP, a faster movement speed, or the power to throw disadvantage on the next person either of you hit. Now, it should be noted that these additional options are available to you regardless of whether you help as a bonus action or a regular action, and they aren't restricted by your proficiency bonus. That only restricts how many times you can use your bonus action, which means that this is either perfect for players who just want to be support helpers forever, or mastermind players who can already pick up help as a bonus action and from 30 feet away. The other abilities are nice, but the F-Hob is definitely for players who want to play off of their party. And speaking of playing off the rest of their party, the Owlfolk definitely does not do that, but I need a segue. What the Owlfolk does do is harness the power of being a motherfucking bird via flight, dark vision, proficiency, and stealth rolls, and the power to ritualistically unravel the secrets of magic, staring through the veil so that they may feast on the knowledge of the arcane. In layman's terms, they can cast detect magic, but only as a ritual, which sort of blows the wind out of the Owlfolk's perspective schick when you have to be like, I can see with my special eyes, but only if you give me 10 minutes to put on my magic seeing contacts. Other than that, they can make a dex save if they're about to crash to flap their wings and readjust, and weirdly enough, you actually get to choose if you want your owlbird to be a small or medium-sized creature. So if you want to play the evil allegory villain from any book that uses mice as a literary device, this is the lineage for you. And the second of the furry incursion and the final lineage of the day is a race that's bad at racing and also makes the internet feel weird feelings when it plays basketball. Like their animalistic cousins, the rabbit folk are always alert for danger, and when it's wabbit season, they manage to stay one step ahead of any Elmer Fuds in the Feywild. And like the owls, their size can either be small or medium, and their exemplary reflexes are represented by a proficiency in both perception and initiative. They can add a d4 to dex saves, and just to really drive home the rabbit theme, they can, once per turn, hop a distance of 1d12 feet for free, which is a skill that, yeah, is original, but as soon as the DM has to start calculating movement that isn't divisible by your normal 5-foot squares, you're going to be seeing a lot more medium-sized lucky rabbit's feet. Also, side note, one of its abilities is called Hair Trigger, spelled H-A-R-E, and I'd really like to know the location of Wizards HQ for non-violent reasons. Overall, I know it's my shtick to hate on the Fey for unspecified reasons, but I'm actually a little disappointed that we didn't delve further into the weirdness of the wild folk. Like, we got an unspecified fairy, a hobgoblin that wandered onto set, and two animal races, none of which, besides ironically the hobgoblin, really exude a feeling that they belong in the Feywild. Like, the Feywild is the world that exists just beyond the darkness of your own eyelids, where dreams and nightmares are reality and lies and truth are the same thing. Every emotion that you've never felt is waiting there to ambush you. And I don't know, I feel like there's more there than just the asshole that steals my Tootsie Pops. Regardless, there's nothing wrong with this UA inherently, and like I say, a lot of this is just my opinion, so my personal idea of what the Feywild should be shouldn't necessarily be indicative of what someone else wants it to be about. It still looks fun, and I'm sure that people will enjoy being able to play a rabbit so that they can escape danger just by a hair. But that'll about do it. I hope you enjoyed this video. Be sure to leave a like, comment, subscribe, ring the bell, check out all my social media in the description below, and maybe support me on Patreon so that I can keep those therapist checks coming for all the conversations that I have about the fairies. But yeah, Davvy out.